हेलो एवरीवन, दिस एस डी परमार एंड अगेन यू ऑल आर वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल डी सी सी डीप कोचिंग क्लास द वर्ल्ड ऑफ बायोलॉजी। दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अबाउट फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, दैट इज द क्लास 12 चैप्टर नंबर 3 फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। अर्लियर इन लास्ट क्लास ऑलरेडी वी हैड टॉक्ड अबाउट मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम इन ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्शन। फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम इज मेड अप ऑफ प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी सेक्शुअल ऑर्गन्स इन विच, सी हियर आई हैव मेड द डायग्राम विच इज़ द रफ रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम। नाउ इफ वी गो इन द डिटेल ऑफ ईच एंड एवरी ऑर्गन ऑफ दिस रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम, वी कैन मैंशन इट और एनालिस्ट इट लाइक primary sexual organs and secondary sexual organs, in which primary sexual organs there will be the pairs of ovary, that is pairs of ovary, ovary is responsible for formation of female gamete or production of female gamete, and we know that the female gamete itself is ova, or in other word we also call it eggs. Ovary is covered with epithelial layer, and this epithelium, it extends the ovary. This thin epithelium will extend the ovary toward uterus. We know that uterus is the part over where fetal development is happening. Fetal development means, we know that in syngamy means sexual reproduction, when there will be mating of ova and sperm, this mating will lead the first formation of the zygote, and from zygote there will be slowly embryogenesis process will be there, and means zygote to embryo and embryo to fetus means the baby who is now ready for the delivery, for the parturition. So this whole process of the fetal development will be ongoing in the uterus. So ovary would be connected via thin epithelium to uterus, connects, or we can also write extends, and the very first part who is very much near to uterus from the ovary means the connective link between ovary and uterus, it is called the infundibulum. Infundibulum who is responsible for the connection of the ovary and the uterus. So that is called, we can see over here the fallopian tube which is leading toward uterus. This is the fundus part. So the very first part which is enclosed to ovary and connects to uterus, this part is called infundibulum. This is infundibulum, and we can see that at the end of the infundibulum, this hair like projection is called femoral, having hair like projection or finger like projection, better to write finger like projections, call, this is known as femoral. Okay, so the primary sexual organ of female reproductive system is ovary. Ovary is covered with the thin epithelium layer which extends the ovary to uterus, and the very first part which encloses the ovary to uterus, extending it toward the peripheral cortex, that is called the infundibulum, which is having at the end portion the finger like projection called fundus. Ovary is also having two main parts, medulla and the cortex, so that also we will mention over here. Periphery cortex, which is the ovarian wall, and the एंड मेड्यूला. ओके, सो ओवरी इज हैविंग टू कंपार्टमेंट, पेरीफेरी कॉर्टेक्स एंड मेड्यूला. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द ओवरी. द सेकेंडरी सेक्शुअल ऑर्गन्स विल बी हैविंग यूट्रस, वजाइना, एक्सटर्नल जेंटिलिया एंड मेमरी ग्लैंड्स. सो लेट अस सी वन बाय वन अबाउट ईच एंड एवरी सेकेंडरी सेक्शुअल ऑर्गन्स ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम. So secondary sexual organs, in which first we are taking, we are going to talk about uterus. The uterus is a pear-shaped structure. In Adhava, we also call it as womb. Now we call mother womb, in which the fetal development happens. That is the uterus. The uterus is consisting of three compartments, which is upper body of uterus, middle body. This upper body of uterus, this one, is called fundus. This one is called fundus, the middle body and the cervix. Okay, so uterus has been divided into three main portions: upper body, middle body and the cervix. The cervix is having sphincter muscles who are responsible for traveling the fetus toward vagina. Means we can also say the cervix is the connective link between uterus and vagina, which is helping the fetus to travel toward vagina by the time of the parturition. And this fundus is the main portion of the uterus over where the whole fetal development is going on. Now, as we were talking about ovary, that the peripheral cortex is extending the ovary toward uterus via fallopian tube. So in fallopian tube, this much thing is also needed to understand, that the fallopian tube, the female reproductive system is having pair of fallopian tubes, in which we can see that one is the broad part and one is the narrow part. So the broad part of fallopian tube, or the broad tube, is called ampulla, and the narrow tube part, this one, is called isthmus. So this is all about uterus. Next is uterine wall or uterine cavity. So uterine cavity is, or uterine wall is, also having three main parts, in which perimetrium, or we can say that these are the three layers of uterine wall. Perimetrium, the middle part, is called myometrium, and inner part is called endometrium. This perimetrium is a thin muscular layer, where the myometrium is made up of thick layer but the smooth muscles. The endometrium is the internal structure, which is having glandular and vascular layers. वजाइना विच इज़ द आउटर स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम विच इज़ रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर रिसीविंग स्पर्म्स एट द टाइम ऑफ कपलेशन. द वजाइना इज हैविंग ग्लाइकोजन रिच मसल्स विच इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर ल्यूब्रिकेशन और द कपलेशन टाइम. सो दिस इज अबाउट द प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम ऑर्गन्स. द लास्ट ऑर्गन विच इज लेफ्ट इन फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम दैट इज द मेमरी ग्लैंड. वी नो दैट मैमल्स आर द ओनली ऑर्गेनिजम्स हु आर हैविंग मेमरी ग्लैंड विच इज द वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट ऑर्गन ऑफ द ह्यूमन रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम एंड ऑल द मैमल्स हु इज द कनेक्टिव लिंक. द बॉन्डेज बिटवीन द मदर एंड द चाइल्ड इज ड्यू टू द मेमरी ग्लैंड. द मेमरी ग्लैंड आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द लैक्टेशन. So let us talk about the structure and the main functions of the mammary gland. So let us talk about first external genitalia before starting about the mammary glands. What is external genitalia? In other words, external genitalia is also called the vulva, and this vulva is having number of consisting parts, in which first is the mons pubis. Mons pubis is the cushion like structure made up of fatty acid tissues, and it is also having the hair, which is the protective organ or the outer structure of the external genitalia. Next is the vestibule. Vestibule is also called the depression of the vulva, which is in front of anus, and it is having two main apparatus: upper external urethra and lower vaginal orifice. So it is the external genitalia is located between vagina and the anus. Vestibule is having two moisture skin structure or the layer of skin which is moisture in nature. It is called labia majora and labia minora. The labia majora is the fleshy fatty acid folds, with the labia minora is the lower skin fold which is hair like structure, internal structure which is having the small and the thin membranes. Hymen. Hymen is the middle head of vulva. It is vaginal opening portion. It is also in other word called the coitus, or sometimes we also call it the seal. We must remember that thing, the seal or coitus is not the indicator of the virginity. The seal could be broken down due to any external accident prone situations or due to any sports or any other reasons. So coitus is a layer which is the opening of the vagina at the first time of the copulation. And the last one is the clitoris, which is the highly sensitive organ of female reproductive system, which is lying in front of the urethral opening. So this is all about the female reproductive system. Now in female reproductive system we will talk about mammary gland.